Chapter 1. He adored Kelowna. He idolized it all out of proportion. No, make that, he romanticized it all out of proportion. To him, no matter what the season was, this was still a town that existed in black and white, pulsated with the great tunes of George Gershwin. Now let me start this over. Chapter 1. He was too romantic about Kelowna, as he was about everything else. He thrived in the hustle-bustle of the crowds and the traffic. To him, Kelowna meant beautiful women and street-smart guys who seemed to know all the angles. Too corny for a man of my taste. Let me try to make it more profound. Chapter 1. He adored Kelowna. To him, it was a metaphor for the decay of contemporary culture. The same lack of individual integrity that caused so many people to take the easy way out was rapidly turning the town of his dreams. It's gonna be too preachy. I mean, you know, let's face it, I wanna sell some books here. Chapter 1. He adored Kelowna, although to him, it was a metaphor for the decay of contemporary culture. How hard was it to exist in a society desensitized by drugs, loud music, television, crime, garbage? Too angry. I don't wanna be angry. Chapter 1. He was as tough and romantic as the city he loved. Behind his black-rimmed glasses was the coiled sexual power of the jungle cat. I love this. Kelowna was his town, and it always would be. We'll be right back.